Good morning students, my name is Madhavi, working in COE Vardhanapet. In the last class we have studied organogenesis in human embryonic development, and today let us see placenta. After implantation, the trophoblast produces finger-like projections called chorionic villi. The chorionic villi and uterine endometrium are interdigitated with each other, and they form a structural and functional unit called placenta between the fetus and the mother. And this placenta prevents the mixing of maternal blood with the fetal blood. The placenta is made up of two components. One is called as maternal part and second one is called as the fetal part. The maternal part is formed from the uterine endometrium, and it has three layers: uterine epithelium, uterine connective tissue and uterine endothelium. The fetal part is derived from the fetal membranes, and it has three layers: fetal capillary endothelium, fetal connective tissue and fetal chorionic epithelium. The placenta in humans is called as chorioallantoic because chorion and allantois fuse with each other. And it is called discoidal because the placental villi, they are seen restricted to only dorsal surface of the blastodisc. And it is called hemochorial because the maternal blood comes in direct contact with the fetal chorion. So when we take, the placenta is basically made up of six layers. In humans, the first five layers, they degenerate and the blood of the mother comes in contact with the fetal chorionic epithelium. So we call it as the hemochorial. And it is called as decidiate because during parturition, along with the baby, the placenta and decidia are shed off, leading to excessive hemorrhage and bleeding. Functions of placenta. Placenta facilitates the transport of oxygen and nutrients to the developing embryo and brings the removal of carbon dioxide and excretory waste from the embryo. The placenta is connected with the embryo by means of umbilical cord, which helps in the transport of the substances to and from the embryo. The placenta secretes the hormone progesterone, which helps in the maintenance of pregnancy after 4th month when corpus luteum starts degenerating. Placenta secretes estrogen, which reaches the maternal blood and brings the uterine growth and development of the mammary glands. Placenta secretes human chorionic gonadotropin, HCG, which helps to sustain the corpus luteum and helps in the production of progesterone. And this HCG is excreted through the maternal urine, and presence of HCG in the maternal urine is used as a test to detect pregnancy. Placenta produces somatomammotropin, which has anti-insulin effect and increases the glucose and amino acid level in the maternal blood, and thus it facilitates more usage of glucose and amino acid by the fetus. Placenta protects the fetus from relatively high blood pressure of the maternal blood. The fetus has both maternal and paternal chromosomes. The paternal chromosomes are foreign to the mother, so it starts producing antibodies. To avoid the rejection from the antibodies, the placenta produces immunosuppressants, and thus it protects the fetus. Thank you, and tomorrow's topic is pregnancy.